That's right. We live up in here, man. I'm your host, King Darius, and I'm representing Blast Global Radio. You already know how we do. I'm here with some good friends of mine, Prime Time, Thomas Johnson, and my man, Lou Crank. What up, though? You know, these gentlemen are professional wrestlers. One of these guys, like myself, is independent, and that's my man, Lou Crank, man. He is the proprietor of his own wrestling company, the Missile Dropkick Wrestling Association. That's MDWA. So I want y'all to show y'all love for my man, Lou Crank, up in here, y'all. This is how we do it.
MDWAwrestling.com.
All right. Now, first off, I want you to tell us how you got started in pro wrestling and what motivated you to promote and start your own company, bro?
Man, you know, every time somebody asks me about what started me in professional wrestling, I got to go back to when my mother, you know, when she used to watch wrestling, her and my brother used to watch wrestling on TV, and it got me geeked up, and I said, that's all I want to do right there is become a professional wrestler. And so that's what got me wanting to become a professional wrestler. And then also, I want to be a promoter because I always enjoyed entrepreneurship, and I always wanted to see somebody that looked like me striving and running their own business and stuff. And that's how I got into promoting. I mean, I just love entrepreneurship, and I wanted to run my own wrestling company. I got motivated because I seen Vince McMahon, and I wanted to be like the black Vince McMahon. So
that's what's up, man. That's why I was attracted to what you was doing, man, because I know that you independent, and you know we represent independence here at Blast Global Radio. You know that's what we're about. So when I came across you, I'm like, oh man, my man got his own independent wrestling company, man. That's what's up, man. So I've been excited more than you, man. All right, my man, Prime Time, man.
What's happening?
How did you get started, man?
Long story. I went all the way to Florida to get, you know, where I wanted to go. I checked around the Michigan area. I really couldn't find a lot. But as I looked in the big magazines, I found out that wrestling was going on down in the Florida area. So, hey, I packed my bags, headed down to the Florida area, and it all started from there.
Okay, that's what's up. Hey, now, did y'all start in high school? Did y'all start this in high school, wrestling in high school?
I wrestled a little bit in middle school, and the high school I had, they didn't have it at the time. So I kind of just had to wait my turn.
No, okay. I didn't actually start at high school, but I tell you where I did start. I started on the street where me and my boys used to make our own little wrestling federations and stuff, and we wrestle each other. My mother used to make cardboard belts for us, and then so we act like what we see on TV, and that's kind of what it gets started. And you know, the wrestling game, you know, before everybody knew it was a performance or it was sports entertainment, they kayfabed you. They never told you where all the schools were, so it was tough for guys like myself and Tommy to actually see where a wrestling school was. But, you know, now they got wrestling schools all the way around the country, so now you get a chance to train and become a wrestler. And also, speaking of that, I do have my own wrestling school, too, called Missile Dropkick Wrestling Academy, too, if anybody's interested.
Okay, that's what's up. So what age requirement do you have to qualify for the MDWA Wrestling Academy?
People can start at the early age of 12 or 13. We recommend it, man. You know, I'm trying to get young people, you know, trained and started right away. But people can start as early as 13 and 14.
Oh, you know? Okay.
As long as they mature and if this is what they want to do, you know.
Okay, that's what's up. So now, you got the MDWA Wrestling Academy, independent wrestling, and now I just hear you just launched your own television network.
Yeah.
Tell us more about that.
Man, you know, it's great. This was a great opportunity because I always had a vision of putting my wrestling company on television, and the first time we did TV, it was in Highland Park, but it was under somebody else's brand. But now we had the opportunity to be on Roku, and so we're on Roku TV now, and you can see us 7 days a week, old content, new content, and I'm excited about this because this is just a whole nother level now. Is, you know, wrestling companies on Roku. You can see we're gonna go live, and you'll have pre-recorded content too. So
okay, that's what's
that.
Up, man. That's what's up. Now, my man, Primetime. Primetime. Now, I know you do a lot of the training for the organization, right? Tell us a little something about that.
Well, you know, you get new guys all the time, all over the, you know, all over Michigan. They want to get into wrestling. They want to talk to people. So I bump into people all the time, just trying to get in business and trying to do things. And you just help guys out. That's basically what I'm doing.
Okay. So what advice would you give somebody who want to get into this game right here?
Yeah, make sure you want to get in it. Because a lot of people get in this and they leave. It's not what they thought it was. If your heart ain't in it, don't waste your money. Don't even bother looking this way. Find something else to like and just sit on the couch and watch wrestling.
That's what's up. That's what's up, man. All right, so how did you guys cross paths? Let me know. Tell me. I'm curious.
So,
because he started messing around in middle school and high school, and you started on the street. So how did you guys cross paths?
Man, that's easy. I went to, I discovered a wrestling school, the HOT wrestling school. And at the time, it was in on the east side of Detroit. Wrestling, and then Tommy was one of the assistant trainers at that school. He was an assistant trainer at the school.
Okay.
And, so he helped a lot of guys like myself, you know, go deep. You know, when we finished training, he'll help us. He'll teach us what he's learned from the great Adrian Street, because Tommy was trained by great Adrian Street. So at the time, my trainer at the time kind of, you know, he took my money and never invested in my career, and I was down about that. And Tommy was there for the evolution of my career. He was there. He helped train me, assisted. He trained me on his off time when he didn't have to do it. He did it. Grabbed me, took me on the road all those times. Went to Eldon, Missouri, and he took me on shows. I had my first match with Tommy in Indiana. And 16 years later, man, you know, he installed a confidence. I remember when Tommy told me that your dream not gonna come at your door and knock on your door. You gotta go out and get it. So that's what I did.
That's what's up, man. Hey, look, and it's a phenomenal show, man. And you won that belt in the championship. Tell us about that, Lou.
Well, yeah, I've been the NDWA Live champion. For a few years now, I've been MDWA Live Champion, and beat some of the best, from Robbie E to Crazy X to a lot of guys that wanted my championship title. I won it at we was doing a show at the Salvation Army, and I beat five men to win this title, and it was a dream come true. But this is a different dynamic, because now it's like, you know, the pupil versus the teacher, you know what I'm saying? Like the kid versus teacher. And this is going to be tough, because he taught me everything, and he knows everything. And I'm happy, because now I get a chance to, you know, wrestle each other on May 21st, and I'm ecstatic. And this is going to be probably one of the toughest matches in my career.
Oh, okay. That's what's up, man, because, hey, man, I really enjoy myself, man, when I come out to the wrestling matches, man, and I enjoy watching Primetime, man. Primetime, man, you put on an excellent show, bro, and I want to commend you for the show that you put on, and the time that you spend, you know, training the wrestlers on what to do and how to do and things of that nature, man. What else you want to add, my man? Primetime.
Hey, I just tell everybody, just give 100%. You're only going to get what you get. You gonna get out of what you put in. You ain't putting 100% in it. Get what you expect. You know, be real to yourself.
And what inspired you, man? What inspired you, man, to do what you do, man?
I'm from the old school with it. I like all the old school wrestling. You know, Mind Leader Giant, from Junkyard Dog, Hulk Hogan, and all of it. That's where it comes. That's where it's happening at. You know, that's what inspired me to come up. Hey, when I was in high school, I told them that's what I was gonna be doing 10 years later. Hey, I'm there.
So, where do you guys see yourself for the next 5 years in this game?
Well,
there's no telling. This is like a roller coaster ride. You don't know where you're gonna turn up.
Yeah, I mean, he said it. He said it all there. It's, you know, I want us to be fully established as a huge company. I want to be doing this full time, and I want to teach all the younger people coming up the right way, and I want to showcase the newer stuff. I just want to keep this game going for a long time. I want to keep this business going for a long time.
Okay, now my man Lou Crank, man.
Lou!
That's how we do it, baby. That's how we do it, man. Hey, look, man. So you have your own independent platform for your wrestling event.
We on Rupal.
Explain to us more about that.
Yeah. So we're independent wrestling company. We're legit. We're LLC. You can find us on Rupal right now. The tagline is MDWA Network. The website is MDWAWrestling.com. May 21st, it's going to be a dynamic show at 29205 on Florence Street in Garden City, Michigan at the Tipton Elementary School. Me and my good brother, Primetime Tommy Johnson, is going to battle a lot for this. You know, like I said, this is a different dynamic. I'm battling somebody that know it all in the business, so it's going to be tough. But we're going to have other great matches there, too. But it's an independent company. We've been running since 2017.
Okay.
And come and check us out. You know, come and check us out. You know, sometimes we do great shows. We do great shows. No Rashi shows. We do good family shows. Please come out and watch and support independent wrestling. MDWA Wrestling.
That's what's up, man. All right, now give us a little rundown on the people who are going to be wrestling at this next event coming up.
Well, as you know, me and my man's, Primetime Tommy Johnson, we're going to be wrestling. He's going for my goal, the MDWA Live Championship. Now you got the Mayor Freedom Ramsey. He's our world champion. Mayor Freedom Ramsey is going against ATL's Reggie Rage. Another young guy that I helped train, Harrison H5. He's a minor league football player. I think he plays for the Michigan Panthers or something like that. I'm saying Michigan Gators, something. But he's a football player. He's gonna be wrestling that night. I don't have the card all on me right now, but we got our new MDWA Women's Champion, Big Boss Anika.
Okay.
And she's going to be teaming up with the Dark Angel, and they're going against Chance, and they're going against Ruby J, the five-star athlete. You got to see the women's action, but much more. You can see the lineup on MDWAWrestling.com. We're going to have a lot. It's a good show. It's a huge show coming up. Guys that I want to say, the Show Up and Show Out show, Tez Cash Carter, and Roy the Working Man,
okay,
for the first time in their career, they're going for gold, for the tag team gold. They're going against the NWA Tag Team Champions, the Cross Brothers, out of Tennessee.
Tough tag team, yeah.
This is a big, tough tag team. But we got a lot of great action. You don't want to see it. At least about 8 matches on the card, though. You don't want to miss it.
Oh, wow, man. That sounds like, man, that's going to be a lot of fun, man. And I appreciate you guys, man, for doing this interview with me. You know, this is Blast Global Radio and TV. This is the station where independence is first. And right here we have NDWA Wrestling. All right? And it's an independent wrestling company, and that's what we're about. We're about promoting independence. So I want y'all to show these brothers some love right here on their efforts.
Before we end, I want Primetime Tommy Johnson to hold the belt, and we both champions. No matter wins or loss, we both won.
There's that right there, Dennis.
Mm-hmm. Y'all get a good look at that belt, y'all. Let you know this right here. It's authentic, baby.
It's the future of professional wrestling. This is Dropkick
Wrestling. Let you know this is authentic, baby. This is what we do. All black, independent wrestling. This is how we do it. We're going to continue to keep it creative and innovative around here. Y'all show your love for my man, Lou Crank, and Primetime Thomas.